Hey everyone, this is Joel with Metrica Sports, and in this video I'm going to show you how to create a coding sequence from scratch along with some really cool tips and recommendations to make your workflow even smoother with Playtree. First thing you want to do is create a new coding sequence and then select the video file you want to work with, the full game. This is post-game coding, we'll talk about the live coding later in this video. Then just create new code. Name it. We're going to do a simple coding, so attack, defense, set pieces. Change all the settings that you want related to the color. Choose the shortcut you want, and most importantly, the saving type. So in this case, we're going to choose recording. When I press the shortcut, it will start recording. When I press it again, it stops. Now we can duplicate this code instead of creating a new one, because I want to keep the same colors I chose for the first one, so I just duplicate it. That's just faster. Change the shortcut, of course, and keep it as a recording mode because that's how we want to record the defense event as well. Create a new one. Make sure everything is exactly how you want it to be. Change any settings that you'd like. Change any settings that you like, and you're ready to go. Now we're going to start adding tags. Tags are what give detail to your codes. We're going to add groups related to the codes that we have. So you can create any tag groups, and inside these tag groups, you can create as many codes as you want and also give them a shortcut. So you can, instead of clicking on them to activate them, you can also use a shortcut. Now, once you set everything up, you can favorite the tags that you want to appear in your code. So for attack code, I just want to favorite the attack tags. For defense code, I want to favorite the defensive tags. So they don't all appear when I'm in record mode. They don't all appear in my element settings. I don't need them all. So for set pieces, I want the set piece tag group to appear, but not all the rest. So I unfavorite what I don't want to appear. Make sure everything is correct, all the settings. I always like to add this code called highlights. So whenever a clip shows up that I know I want to show it later to my staff, to my players, I call it highlights. And it's just going to be an instant save 25 seconds before. So when I see it, I click to save this code and he will record the 25 seconds that just passed. This is enough to get the whole play. Now, once everything is ready, change from edit mode to record mode. And then it's the usual routine of watching the game. Remember, you can change the speed so you can code faster. While you're coding, you can always revert to the edit mode and change anything you want about it. In this case, I want to add shortcuts to my tags, so I don't have to click them all. Maybe the ones I use the most, like low block or high block, build up, final third, I think I'm going to use it a lot. I'm going to add a shortcut to it, so it's just faster. It's up to your preference. You can always change that. Here's a very cool recommendation. If you're recording a code just like this one and you click somewhere else like I did to change the speed and the code stopped recording, don't worry. You don't need to go back to the beginning to start recording it again. Just click on the code and put the needle in the time that you want that code to end and then press Shift O. Very useful shortcut. You will use it a lot. If you make a mistake, you can always change the code to the bottom one, to the one above. Just grab it, put it there. And of course, if you use Command Z, you can revert any action that you've done, put it back as it was. Now, let's say you want to import an XML, whether you've done it with Playtree or from another provider, you can import any. You can click on them and it goes to the start of that clip. If you want to narrow down your search, just click the filter button. It's this icon right here in your timeline. And you can filter by ID, by the exact name of that code. Just search for it and filter it, or you can just write it down, whichever code that matches the letters. Like in this case, shots, there are two different codes called shots, so it will show you both of them. And you have this icon right here, the eye, that will hide everything that does not match your search. When you filter, the events that belong to that code will be automatically selected, and you can see in the event info in your element settings how many events are there. If you press Command and click, you will select the events that belong to that code. If you want both of these shots, press Command Shift and click on the other code to select all of the events, in this case, all the shots. And if these are the events that you want to use to put it on the playlist and continue your telestration work, just double click on any of the event and save it to a new folder or to a selected folder. Now let's talk about clip descriptors. This is a very cool option that is going to save you a lot of time. In the options above the video canvas, you can change anything you want about the title, the notes, the tags, the colors, the size, the position. You can make it exactly as you want it. Every change you make will apply to all the videos. This will save you a tremendous amount of time. Instead of adding text boxes, you have the descriptions that let you know exactly what that play is about. It's a very, very powerful tool. Once you've created your codes, you can save that as a template, share it with your staff. Of course, you can save it as an XML as well. If you double click this empty part in your coding sequence, you'll see all the options that you have and the shortcuts that you can use. Now let's talk about live recording. If you go to the live settings, you'll find all the options available here. If you have a capture card and your camera connected to your computer, it will be automatically recognized and it will show up in this menu. If you want to do a ghost capture, meaning you don't have a video source and you want to code it live, it will work in the same way without a video source or with a live camera. Just load your coding template or create it, start the recording, and start your coding process. Now, when you finish your capture, whether it's halftime or it's full game, you just stop the recording. In case this was a ghost capture where you had no video source, you just go and select the video file that you want to add, and that's it. In case this was a live capture, you'll have the recording of your video in the organizer. Now you're ready to start your telestration work. This is just a short example of how you can create some really nice videos. I'm using the polygon feature to group the players together as a team. Now I'm going to use the distance to see how far is my central defender from my main striker. And here's a cool tip. If these players have already been tracked, you don't need to track these again. Just extend the bar. Another cool trick with the distance, if you want to just move the text, hold down command and click on the distance and move it to exactly where you want it to be. In this example, I'm building a pause. I want my striker to press the opposing defender, force him into the line, press him against the line. So I add some arrows. Here's another cool tip. When you're building pauses just like this one, and you want to adjust the end of all these annotations to put up at the same time, you can just select it all using Command A or select them one by one holding down the Shift key and then use Shift O to adjust the end time of these annotations to exactly where the needle is. Very useful. Another cool recommendation, this happens sometimes. So when the visuals look like this, a bit faded, all you have to do is click on the chroma, adjust settings and add these colors who are missing from it. That's it. Once you've finished your animation, you can still trim. In this case, I want a shorter clip. I'm going to trim the end and I'm going to trim the beginning by holding these yellow markers and pulling them exactly to where I want them to start and to end. You can change the description of your clip by just changing the name of the clip in your organizer. It will reflect on the descriptor. The notes as well are very useful. This is a huge time saver. Instead of adding text boxes, just change it right here and it's done. Now, once you're done, you can export it as a video to share with the players or staff, export as a container, present from within the software with full screen or second screen option. So many things you can do with it. I hope this video was helpful. It showed you a complete workflow, how easy it is and time saving. I hope this was helpful. Enjoy.